Hello, this is Rory with the Love Chat, and today's topic is, where do I meet people to date? Now, this is video number 206. If you have a question you'd like for me to consider featuring on the Love Chat, please write it in a comment below, and if you enjoy my videos, I would be so very, very grateful if you'd subscribe and hit like. So thank you if you have, and if you haven't, well, I appreciate you checking out my video anyway. So, if you'd like coaching on your situation, just visit my website, thelovechat.net/coaching. So, I'm making this video as a dating video for those of you who are looking to step back into the game, and this is basically going to be about meeting people for dating that are actual good suggestions rather than the same old crappy ones. Now, I did throw in dating apps, and I'm going to explain a bit more about my thoughts on dating apps. Most of you from listening to my channel know I don't particularly like them, but we'll get into that. It's a list-based video, so let's just jump right into number one, which is through mutual friends and mutual friends parties. So this is where you go to a party, you're hanging out with your friends, you're having a good time, and hey, somebody you don't know happens to be there. That's a fantastic way to meet them because there's already a degree of safety. They know that you know so-and-so, and they know so-and-so, and so-and-so is not insane, so you're probably not insane. Obviously, you still need to go make yourself available and start a conversation, which, if we're being honest, is the part that most people struggle with. It's not so much where to meet these people, but it's how to meet them in such a way that makes you feel comfortable. But we've also discussed before that, you know, some of the best ways to overcome adversity is just to face it and be done with it. But having a list like this certainly couldn't hurt. So the second one is college or university or whatever form of schooling or education you're working with right now. Now, this one is particularly useful because of peer groups. You'll find yourself in constant contact with so many of your different peer groups or social groups that it's inevitable that eventually something romantic sparks if you're putting yourself out there. But again, from the comfort of your dorm room, you're not going to find anybody unless you make the effort. You have to put yourself out there, and that will go for every single one of the things that I've put on this list. So really, that's the main skill you're going to want to start tackling. Now, number three, and this one is less recommended, but work. When you're at work, I take a don't shit where you eat mentality, but I realize for many people who work long hours, work may be the only time you meet people. And so what I would say is, if possible, try dating people at work who don't at least work under you or near your station where you're going to see them all the time, depending on what sort of company or organization you work for. If you can, try to date somebody in a different department where you'll never really make contact with them at work. It's better that way, so there's less cross-contamination. Number four, make new friends as an objective rather than dating. So many of these different videos and coaches that you listen to say, well, you should make your romantic interest known almost immediately and you should tell them exactly what you need. But in a lot of the cases that I see, some of the best and strongest romances come from people who you trust. And if you think about it in terms of growing exponentially, the more friends you have, the wider pool of potential that you have, because not only might your friends become romantically interested in you, but the people that they can introduce you to can also become romantically interested in you. So you grow exponentially by becoming interested in people, rather than interesting for people. So after this point, number five is something that not many people think about. Think about volunteer work in your community. You'll find that it's a win-win because not only are you meeting people and doing something really great and local, so not only will you be meeting people of all different age groups, but you'll be rewarded because you're doing something that is ultimately intrinsic. You're getting good feelings because you're doing something. For me personally, I spent some time working with animals, and I would also work with children with autism from time to time because I found that that was rewarding for me. And so really, we're given the opportunity to kill two birds with one stone. You can meet new people who you find to be interesting and feel like you're fulfilling a social need, and by proxy, a potential romantic need. And also, you get to do something good for yourself, good for your community, good for the soul. And so that's why this is one of my favorite ones on the list. After volunteer work, we have attending local events in your community. Now, maybe this is art galleries or museums, festivals. Maybe it's just a concert. Who knows who you'll bump into? Who knows what situations you'll be introduced to simply because you gave life a chance and you said yes? I think this is another one of those things that's going to help you overcome perhaps some of the social anxieties that you've worked up to. Invite some existing friends and say, hey, let's go to a festival, and because you feel good and safe because you're with friends in a trusted group, I bet you'll be more likely to go out and live life and have fun. Number 7. Yuck. Dating apps. I do hate online dating, I really do. I understand that no matter how much I complain about it, it's not going to go away. So, here's my main issue with it, and then I'll explain why I added it on this list. My main issue is that you never need to face rejection on a dating app, because you never know when somebody said no. The app itself has nothing to do with that part. Now, if you're talking to somebody and you don't get along, they might say no. If you go on a first date and there was no chemistry, they're probably gonna say no. But dating apps pardon you from rejection because you only match with people who said yes to you, and you're never faced with the ones that said no until you've already matched. I firmly believe that one of the biggest problems of dating, especially in our generation, is that we need to learn how to be rejected and be told no and get over it and allow ourselves to grow from that experience so that we no longer fear it. And my problem is that dating apps pardon you completely from that experience. You're never told no. You're only informed when you're told yes. And sometimes you must acknowledge that you're never going to get over the fear of being rejected if you avoid it completely. So if that's the case, then why did I include it on this list? Well, because I acknowledge the fact that everybody might be placed in different life circumstances. Perhaps you work weird hours and the only time you're going to be able to meet people is on planned dates. Perhaps you are extremely socially anxious and going out and doing some of these things is out of the question. There are a couple more reasons like that that I can think of, but without wasting any more of your time, let's move on to number 8, which is class-based fitness. Now, this is not solo gym training. What I mean by that is this is not you walking into a gym, working out at a machine, and approaching a random stranger who happens to be working out and saying, hey, want to get coffee sometime? Because they're not going to feel particularly safe. Specifically, this is a male-to-female problem, as the men are usually the ones who do this, and women are usually the ones who don't feel very comfortable with that. And I'm not saying this never works. I'm not saying it never happens. I suppose I'm just saying, why not go for a bit more of the social aspect, where you're seeing the same people at the same time, on the same day each week, and you become friends with them, and who knows what can happen next. Things like yoga, weight classes, kickboxing. These are places you meet people. They get to know you. They form a certain level of comfort with you, and your success is actually raised because they see you as a more safe, reasonable, controlled option. But if I'm randomly approached by somebody at the gym, I might feel kind of weird about it, even like, ugh, I'm all sweaty and gross and ugh. But it's completely reasonable after a rather intense gym class to say, hey, you want to go grab some Starbucks? And then you simply let nature do its thing. So, number 9, the last one for today is trivia at local bars. Now, usually I'm really, really skeptical about the bar scene, but this is a very specific scenario where you're going and the point is not to get completely blasted at a bar and go home with a stranger. It's to go have a drink, have some fun playing trivia, and be in the mood to laugh and learn something new. And oh, how did I forget that one? I could have gotten that one. And you'll meet people there who are doing the same thing, and there's a feel-good mood. And then you can sit down, get to know each other over drinks, maybe order some food, and just enjoy yourself. Everybody gets so serious about dating that we forget that the point of dating is to have fun. And so if you can't have fun with one another, you're not really dating. The biggest thing I can say in this video is to learn how to speak to random people. Men, women, however you self-identify, stop treating them as genders and start treating them as people. Stop viewing them differently, and you won't have the social anxiety that comes with that. This goes even more so, particularly for the younger viewers in the audience who are dealing with a lot of social anxiety. Look, the best way to get over it is to go through it. You find people in life out while you're living it, rather than from the comfort of your bedroom. So I encourage you to go out, try something new, and say yes to life far, far more than you say no. Because you can do it, and it is exciting, and it's fun, and you get to recreate who you think you can be. Because you're a machine that's built and designed to adapt and overcome. And so if you can do that, if you can push yourself and say yes more than you say no, you'll find that it really is an enjoyable experience. And like I said earlier, you find people in life out while you're living it. Now, I believe I promised everybody here a free coaching contest, so here it is. All you need to do is like the video and in the comments below, write down how my content has helped you facilitate a better life for yourself or the life of another person. Just type your answer down below in this video, and a winner will be announced on the 29th of November 2019. I realize that some people are going to be listening to this video long after it's been produced. And lastly, I'll be giving away two coachings, so I will be selecting two people who will both get a free 1 hour coaching. So, best of luck to everybody who enters, and we'll see you next time.